2013年的12月9号，六位来自北美、亚洲和欧洲的医生和律师赶赴联合国总部日内瓦，他们将150万来自全球的呼吁联合国调查中共从法轮功学员身上摘取器官谋求暴利的请愿签名交给联合国人权理事会高级专员办公室。
1.5 million signatures in the space of 5 months is a phenomenal response from the public globally.
It's really the sign the power of the truth.
与此同时，在法国斯特拉斯堡，欧洲议会的议员们正在讨论通过一项关于谴责中共从法轮功学员身上摘取器官的决议。
A huge shady and immoral business of organ selling to foreigners has developed in China.
Systematic, state-sanctioned organ harvesting from non-consenting prisoners of conscience,
especially from Falun Gong prisoners of conscience,
is happening today in front of our eyes.
It's absolutely unacceptable and should be ended immediately.
欧盟这个层次啊，可能是第一个这么清楚、这么直截了当的谴责中共活在反共学院是吧。
I totally support this resolution. We should condemn it more strongly.
We ask the EU member states to condemn publicly the corrupt and immoral organ transportation business.
It is the European Parliament's obligation to condemn decisively the actions of the Chinese government in this appalling issue.That touches the core of human dignity and the fundamental right to life.
The human life is as precious, as valued in China as elsewhere in the world. And this is exactly what we are going to say with this resolution.
12月初的欧洲寒风凛冽，在布鲁塞尔欧洲议会大楼外，一群人在舒缓的音乐中无声地表达他们的诉求，抗议中共对和他们持有同样信仰的中国民众长达14年的迫害，尤其是从他们身上活体摘取器官谋取暴利的行为。
This is a terrible crime against humanity in China. It's been going on for too many years and it has to stop.
一张张传单发到进出欧洲议会的议员和工作人员的手中，身处民主、自由与人权等基本价值的发源地，大楼中的议员们正在考虑如何行使他们作为28国欧洲公民直接选举出来的代表所必须履行的义务和权利。
What the European Parliament can do concretely for the next week is to have an urgency debate and resolution about organ harvesting.
It would be very good if we could have the resolution, and that's why we urge them to vote for this.
与此同时，欧洲的法轮功学员致信或致电自己国家的欧洲议会议员，呼吁他们关注中共活摘器官的罪行，并通过决议谴责此事。
Is it possible to speak with MEP Brastas?
We mainly focused on Belgium MEPs because I'm a Belgian citizen. I would like to give some update about the organ harvesting issue. In the beginning, it was all on the surface level. They will look into it. They even said probably it's the time slot. It's too short to have a resolution passed. But yeah, of course, we continue.
那时候，距离决议最终投票只有不到2个星期的时间。
I had this feeling when I will not stop.Although they say it's too short, this is for the next session. I think to have this faith and this strong hold on that this thing has to be passed now, it also make a change for them, I think.
此外，有15个国际组织或团体陆续致信欧洲议会，要求议会能够通过这项紧急决议。于是，这份谴责中共从良心犯，特别是从法轮功学员身上摘取器官的决议，开始在欧洲议会中酝酿，并迅速得到了知情议员的支持。
Concerning Falun Gong and human organ harvesting,
This is especially shocking form. And I would say that we have to send a very clear message.
For us, that is not acceptable. It must stop now, and it must stop everywhere and against anybody.
In my group, I was one of the initiators of this resolution, and it is clearly among the priorities of our group. There was no debate, no opposition to it.
然而，活摘器官这一指控的惨烈超出了人们所能认可的底线。经历过二战中纳粹的种族灭绝，又经历了苏共的铁腕统治和屠杀，本以为灭绝人性的史书那一页已然封存，走在宽敞明亮的议会大楼，议员们无法想象，也无法相信，当他们喝着咖啡处理公文的时候，在同一块欧亚大陆的另一端。 活生生的人被储存在集中营，按照器官移植的需求被杀害。
It reminds me of the young Polish man who got out of Poland in 1941, having been into the death camps. And he went to London and he went to Washington to try and tell the Allies what was happening in the death camps. And a famous judge called Felix Frankfurt, who was himself Jewish, was asked by a journalist, "You did not believe what this young man was saying." You called him a liar. He said, no, I didn't say he was a liar. I just said, I cannot believe what he's telling me. And that's the real problem with this subject.
为了证明活摘器官的真实存在，麦克米兰斯考特先生2006年曾亲自前往中国大陆，会见牛进平、曹东两位法轮功学员，并将他的调查过程和结果整理成了报告。
He said he could only tell me that he had a friend, another Falun Gong practitioner, in the prison. The friend disappeared one day, and the next time he saw him was his body, the friend's body, in the prison hospital with holes where body parts had apparently been removed.
除此之外，另一份由著名人权律师撰写的独立调查报告，更是为活摘器官的确切存在提供了权威性的证据。
The allegation and our findings are shocking. I mean, to us, this is a form of evil we have yet to see in this planet.
2006年，加拿大前亚太司司长、律师大卫·乔高和加拿大人权律师大卫·麦塔斯对活摘法轮功学员器官一事展开独立调查，并以律师特有的客观严谨的态度。 将获得的详实证据和结果整理成《血腥的活摘器官》一书，随后他们陆续奔赴全球40多个国家公布他们的调查结果，这其中也包括欧洲议会。
The bloody harvest, the killing of Falun Gong for their organs.
许多议员正是通过这两个大卫的造访以及他们权威性的调查报告，了解到了中共活摘法轮功学员器官的真相。
When I met David Kilgour. Who was the Minister of Justice in Canada and who is a lawyer himself and who is an author? And he told me that yes, incredible as it sounds, but the most wonderful people in China, the most civilized and wonderful people, they refuse to believe this. It's so incredible, which means that it's a very sinister practice, which is adopted by a very narrow circle of Chinese society.
在调查报告出炉后。 全球的法轮功学员开始利用一切可能的机会，告诉各国民众，在中国发生的活摘器官的事情。Organ
harvesting from prisoners sentenced to death, even today, are still happening.
这其中不乏与活摘器官的命运擦身而过的幸存者。How
many of you have been blood tested while you have been detained? Right. Think about it, everybody. The Chinese regime. Persecute these people. They torture them with the heinous means. Why would they care about their blood? What they're taking their blood for?
这样的幸存者也来到了欧洲议会的门外。刘玉梅是被联合国营救到芬兰的法轮功学员，她的父母、妹妹、丈夫都因为修炼法轮功被中共迫害致死或含冤离世。 他自己也曾经被抓捕过9次，并被迫害致伤残。
我在被关押期间呢，警察就是告诉我，说你不报姓名和地址哈，就给你刨心挖肝连尸体都找不着。在我这个姐姐在马三江。 迫害苍松的也进行一系列的进行那个身体检查。
这次他从芬兰专程赶来，作为迫害的第一见证人进入了欧洲议会，向芬兰议员亚格萨利的助手讲述了自己的亲身经历。刘玉梅自己曾饱受类风湿关节炎所苦，修炼法轮功40天后便摆脱了病魔，却在中共的9次非法抓捕、30多种酷刑的折磨下被迫害致残，4次生命垂危。父亲70多岁时曾被煤矿车碾过，造成全身粉碎性骨折，医院不愿动手术。回家后，父亲通过学练法轮功，不长时间便能下地干活。
那车都没压死，这会在这迫害中迫害的是。
在这活生生的血泪控诉中，议员的助手红了眼眶。
他就觉得太不可思议了。他说：“我尽我的最大努力，我支持你们。”我也通过我的刚我的议员，刚我的刚其他的正义人士支持你们。完，当时走时候又和我拥抱。
在知情议员和法轮功学员的共同努力下，活摘器官一事终于在议会召开全体会议前形成正式决议，等待投票通过。12月9号，欧洲议会的议员们按照惯例来到法国斯特拉斯堡的另一座议会总部大楼举行全体会议。走在温暖的大楼内，议员们隔着玻璃窗望着在大雾和低温中日复一日的和平请愿的法轮功学员。没有口号，没有喧哗，这群人请愿的方式与其他任何的抗议团体都不一样，却于无声中展现了坚韧的力量。
The demonstrations outside the European Parliament are very crucial to raise awareness.
议员们开始思考、谈论，这个即将在3天后进行投票的紧急决议到底是怎么回事？对他们来说又意味着什么
？I want to remind the quotation from Dante in Inferno: "The worst places in the hell are reserved for those who stay aside during the time of moral crisis." We are now in moral crisis, so we should act.
这一天。欧洲议会并不是唯一一个讨论与思考活摘器官真实发生的道德危机中该如何行动的地方。在欧洲的另一个举足轻重的国际中心日内瓦，6位来自全球各地的医生和律师带着一封信来到了联合国人权理事会高级专员办公室。薄薄的信件承载的却是150万来自全球各地民众郑重署名的心愿。近150万签名经过扫描并刻入光碟后，已经从12月3号开始由各国寄给联合国人权理事会高级专员办公室。
I think we contributed to raise even more awareness to raise the understanding of this problem.
这项征签活动是一个叫做 DAFO 的非政府组织发起的。
DAFO or Doctors Against Forced Organ Harvesting.Started after a group of U.S. doctors came together, and they noticed there's a lot of unethical organ harvesting being done around the world. And when they started doing investigation, they realized in China that in the thousands, people forced organ harvesting was happening, and they were really moved by it. So they wanted to do something about it. They formed an NGO, and then they started asking doctors from around the world to get involved.
越来越多的医学专家加入了 DAFO， 并在世界各地奔走呼吁，制止中共活摘器官的行为。
The only possible way is if there's a living pool of donors that is systematically organized, ready to be harvested.
2013年的中旬 ，DAFO 发起了一项涵盖全球4大洲的征集签名的活动。呼吁民众关注这一违背人性基本价值的罪恶行径。
How come you're signing this petition?
For human rights.
Almost everyone
which you had the chance to explain what this petition was about, they immediately wanted to sign this petition. Some of them were very supportive. They even took some papers out of our hands and started to collect signatures for themselves on the spot.
12月10号世界人权日，达佛的代表及其律师顾问在日内瓦湖畔就向联合国递交签名仪式举行了新闻发布会。
所以我们在此地谈的不只是法轮功问题，我们谈的是整个人类面临反人类罪的一个态度，一个维护普世价值的一个非常重要的事情。
The impact is very important. The Mamba state can understand, learn more about the situation.
I'm ready here in our premises, the European Economic and Social Committee, to invite all the European leaders and all the other European institutions to launch an appeal to support this campaign.
Parce que vraiment, tout le monde doit signer.
日内瓦新闻发布会的第二天，另一位达佛的成员赶赴法国斯特拉斯堡，参加欧洲议会负责人权事务的副主席麦克米兰斯考特先生就活摘器官召开的新闻发布会。
This increase cannot be explained by the official version of organs donated by the annually decreasing number of prisoners condemned to death, but only by the regulations of ethical standards related to forced organ harvesting in China.
这时距离决议最终投票只有不到一天的时间。欧洲议会2013年度的最后一个工作日，投完票的议员已经开始陆续离开议会总部大楼，而在议会大楼外，法轮功学员的请愿依旧继续着。寒风吹透层层衣衫，他们却获得了意想不到的温暖。
大概在中午一点钟左右，从大厦里面出来一位40多岁的中年女性，在我跟她打完招呼之后，她主动地对我说：“我是人权协会的主席，我支持你们，我有一个博客，欢迎你去访问我的博客。”
不仅是议员，从大楼中出来的有议员的助理、翻译、工作人员，他们是专门来签字、合影，或者是向寒风中默默请愿的法轮功学员表达问候的。
有一位40多岁的中年的男士，他说他不是议员，他不能投票，但是呢，他很希望能够来到我们的这个展台前亲自签字，来表明他们的支持态度。好几个人主动地说，你们做的这件事情十分的重要，让大家明白了这个真相太重要了，感谢你们。
12月12号的傍晚，投完票的议员已经陆续离开议会总部大楼，而关于这项决议的辩论仍旧在会议大厅内紧张地继续着。
We have to express our deep concern over persistent and credible reports of systematic state-sanctioned organ harvesting from non-consenting prisoners of conscience,
including from Falun Gong practitioners. According to the information I received, imprisonment for their religious beliefs is absolutely unacceptable.
The government launched a nationwide persecution to eradicate the traditional and peaceful spiritual practice of Falun Gong. This follows the principles of truth, compassion, tolerance.
Diese Organentnahme, pardon, ist schockierend und widerspricht jeglicher Vorstellung von menschlicher Würde.
Je pre mňa nepochopiteľné, že národ s takou bohatou kultúrou a civilizáciou vôbec začal s takýmto dekadentným prístupom k ľudskému organizmu.
然而，辩论过程中也有少数质疑的声音。对此，德国的议员米歇尔·加勒做出了这样的回答
：“Also, ich frage mich wirklich, sind denn die Opfer normalerweise nicht die besten Zeugen dafür, was ihnen zugestoßen ist? Oder welche Grund sollte denn Menschen haben, hier etwas Falsches zu behaupten, wenn es nicht ihnen tatsächlich oder ihren Familienangehörigen zugestoßen ist? Und das erinnert mich fast an die Zeiten, wo die Opfer von Stalins oder Hitlers Konzentrationslager nachweisen mussten, dass es wirklich so schrecklich war. Das kann doch nicht Sinn der Sache sein. Nur weil eine Diktatur sich diese Intransparenz leisten kann, dann das in Zweifel zu ziehen, das, was die Opfer uns erzählen.
We ask the EU member states to condemn publicly the corrupt and immoral organ transportation business.
It is the European Parliament's obligation to condemn decisively the actions of the Chinese government in this appalling issue that touches the core of human dignity and the fundamental right to life.
最终，这个由议会七个党团中的五个党团联合发起，六个党团表示支持的决议，以获得多数赞成票得以通过。决议呼吁欧盟及其成员国公开谴责这种不道德的器官交易，并将此告知欧洲公民。决议还要求议会主席将该决议送达欧盟委员会、欧洲理事会、联合国人权理事会及中国政府。
The European Parliament is the voice of 500 million Europeans.
We built the European Union on values, freedom, democracy.
This behavior is not accepted by the world community.
从2006年活摘器官曝光，到两个大卫的报告出炉，再到如今欧洲议会通过决议公开谴责这一暴行，已经过去了将近十年的光阴。
We should have done it that earlier, but I think we have learned very much during this process of support. And now we are much more clear about what is going on in China and much more determined to continue our support and express our solidarity toward our Chinese friends.
如今，发起这项决议的议员们希望中国民众能明白，这是他们发出的善意的讯息。
This resolution is the decision of the European Parliament to do something is addressed to the People's Republic of China.
I very much hope it will be received positively, like a goodwill of people who care.
I understand that, and sometimes China, like Russia, thinks that the West is imposing.Which is nonsense, of course, because I think that the West owes really much to China itself, to the courage of Chinese dissidents, Chinese writers and human rights defenders, people who were fearless and so courageous. It's something deeply universal, something that is related to, I would say, common denominator adopted by all civilized countries.
This thing is not a simple, simple 政党之间的政治问题。其实这个问题是关系到全人类的以后未来的生存，因为人呢、啊，人类社会没有最基本的道德观念是很难运转的。